Oh!
Ah! Cavron!
Perfecto mundo.
That is strange.
Not really. It happens to me every day.
You ask me that question. Oh, yeah. You say that all the time.
It does.
Just to make me feel like I'm not as crazy as I am. Well, that's very kind of you.
Yeah, that's true.
That's true.
That it happens to me every day.
Uh-huh.
Or that you're crazy. Both, yeah. Maybe. Yeah.
I tried a third one. And like I said, that suggestion of a landscape in the back was what I thought of for a bit when I was doing the sketches, but I don't think I will. Isn't this exciting? Just waiting for me to drill this through my finger, right? Been done. Anyway, I think that's enough for now. Progress is slow. Messy, dusty. You can see the textures of the removed woods, maple. And now I start removing things, areas, small amounts, leaving textures, which are gonna become darker areas, leaving them even where I intend to have white. The ink goes on here, gets rolled onto four or five rollers by the master roller underneath, and makes a bit of noise, so I'll be starting that noise quite soon. I've got some ink all mixed up. I'll make a pass over it to ink the block up once. Make a second pass. And then click it over to print. Get a piece of paper in there. Cross my fingers and hope it works. This is the block so far. And here's the print. You can see the print is a reversal of the block, the image on the block. I don't throw away paper if there's a proof on one side and it's clean on the other. I proof it on the other side. This is the backside of another print that I ran called I Made Up My Mind. The next step, I'll sit down with that print and decide what more I need to remove. I'll also maybe consider whether or not I've removed too much. And if I have removed too much, there's nothing I can do about it but adapt. And once I've made the decision as to what to remove more, then I'll take another proof. And I'll keep proofing until I'm satisfied that the block looks the way I want it to look. So, think about one more time. Lock some paper in the carriage and see what happens this time. Now I've added one more piece of bond paper to the back, glued it on there with a glue stick in that area there, which was a lighter area. Just needs a little more pressure. I'll go get the other previous proof before I did this recent engraving. You can compare them. You can see that over here, the first one, those areas that I left, now I have removed them. I worked a little more down in here too. So now I'll study it and see how much more I need to do. Take my time. Don't want to remove any more than I have to. There we go. That should be good, and it should work. Okay, number 44, fly fishing. But I've got to go slow enough that ink has a chance to stay on the paper. Time to add another spot of ink. And let that spread. Okay, one extra pass. It's a noisy old cantankerous press. It's
kind of like the operator, maybe?
Yeah, sort of like the operator. Getting old and cranky, grumpy. And it's, I think it's about 55, 60 years old, this press.
Tell us about how it got its name.
The Spanish Fly Press, or the Spanish Fly is its name. The press is my name. I was doing a series of wood engravings of insects, and in doing my research for insects, to look up different insects, find a little bit about them, find out some that I had never seen before. I was looking through bug books and came across an entry in the book about Spanish fly, which I always thought was a myth.
What kind of myth? What are you talking about?
Well, I didn't think it really existed.
What are we talking about here? What's the myth?
You want me to go into the whole story of what a Spanish fly is?
Maybe the Coles Notes version.
Oh. Well,
how many times did you try it yourself before you realized it was a myth? I'm being so mean to you, Jim. I know. You don't have to answer that.
Yeah, I won't.
But the name, that's where the name came from.
Okay. Well, and one of the reasons was I was printing that series at the time on this press. And the prints were doing quite well. They seemed to be quite popular in shows and things like that. So I just honored the press by giving it that name of this mysterious insect that comes from northern Spain, southern France, in that area, and has some toxin in its body that they say is an aphrodisiac. But apparently, if this is ingested in a certain small, very small amount, it can be lethal. It's deadly. It's a poison. So whether it's an aphrodisiac or not, I don't really know, but it is poison. Learning additions can become a little tiresome. It's repetitive, climbing up the ladder, going down the ladder. You can become rather, I don't know what the term would be, complacent or forgetful, running a kind of repetitive series of motions like this and leave some things out or do one of the steps wrong. That slows things down. That click that I just make there each time is to keep the rollers away from this cylinder. Otherwise I'd be printing that image on the cylinder, which would then print on the back of the next print. Right. If the block didn't have that much black in it, I wouldn't need to go so slow as to let that black, you know, get in the paper, because the lines would fill okay, or print okay. Now I have to raise this up. There's no sense putting any more ink on the block. So I raise the rollers, turn the old Spanish fly off. Ah, oh, quiet.
Relief. So now, what happens to the block now that you've run the...
I used to take the tool and run a gouge, a cut across it, and cancel the block.
And you do that, obviously,
The integrity of the run. If I say there's 40 plus 4, there's artist proof, there are. And when I was starting the series of nursery rhymes, Mother Goose Eggs, Sunny Side Up, I had run 3 or 4, and then I decided to do a book and to print the book myself. Well, I'd already run editions. That meant that I had to print the blocks onto paper, which would then be bound into the book. And I was going to do that myself, not the binding, but the printing. And print it, you know, handset type. I've got the type drawers over here. They've got type in them. And I was going to handset the type, do the text and the nursery rhymes, and print the wood engravings. And then I got to thinking, if ever I wanted to print a book after running an edition, and I have canceled the block, there's no way I can do it. So I don't cancel them. I put them away, store them, And then when I know that I'm not going to do anything like a book, then I'll cancel them. That'll come later. So now, it's cleanup time, but you do not want to see that or smell it. The last one. Oh, no!
What happened?
I don't know. I'll show you.
Uh-oh. Smudge.
I must have picking up the block.
Oh, shit.
Right?
Yeah.
Good thing I didn't clean the block, isn't it?
Yeah.
So I'm not through.
Uh-oh. That sucks.
Bleep, bleep,
bleep,
bleep, bleep.
You want to throw a tantrum for the blooper reel?
Yeah. Oh. Well, I've got to clean it and start over. Oh, well, these things happen.
Yep.
If I was alone, I'd say something or...
Say it now. Well, tell us what you'd say if you were alone, Jim.
Okay, if I divide, let's see, 40 divided by 11 equals a little over 3.5. I could have done that in my head, of course, but this is faster. You heard that old carpenter's adage, haven't you?
Measure twice, cut once.
That's right. I don't put a lot of pressure. It's better to cut it, and then you notice my left hand is kind of going like an inchworm. Have you ever seen an inchworm? You didn't see that, did you?
Nope.
Good. Ah! Yeah, having fun. Where's that one I screwed up? That'll go underneath. Didn't screw up much, by the way. Can't even find it. Come on. That's strange. I know the knife drifted off just a hair. It's weird. It's got to be seen somewhere. Maybe I dreamed it. Try to guess what I'm talking about or singing about.
What do you got so far?
I can't speak Spanish. Not much. I can't speak Spanish. Just individual words. What have I got here? I better not go by that. I've done some changes, so I need to throw that away or I'm going to get... screwed up. 3.75. 3.75. Perfecto mundo. Oops, I need more. Which probably didn't go through the map. So, do it again. Oh, they've got a bird in that song. I'm sure we don't have a bird in this room. No. 3.25 there. That ain't 3.25 there. Cabron! What is wrong here? Cabron? 3.25. I want 3.25. That should have been 3.25. But it was 3.5. Still off. What am I doing wrong? That's 3.25. Okay, we'll do that licking thing again.
How's it taste?
Tongue.
How's it taste?
Terrible. I felt like stamps used to be. Sure glad they started that. Mm-hmm. Self-stick'em stamps. Aren't you?
Yep.
You know, don't have to lick this tape. Bleep, bleep,
bleep,
bleep, bleep.
No luck?
That's right, he doesn't have a cell. He lost it.
You're calling his dead cell.
Calling his dead cell.